Winner, winner, token minority dinner. That's right. If your MFC is going to win, he's going to win the right way. He's not going to win against a completely defeated Wizard Sleevers or a can't set his lineup right Willis Dick fit in your mouth. See, I got cats cheering for me in the background. Derrick Henry did what he could. Jared Goff showed up for once. Threw some passes and some TDs. Who showed up for Token Minority? Everybody. Except for DeAndre Hopkins. The point is, MFC's back on the right track. Got a parlay bet with the whole league. If me and the Chubb end up in the 1 and 2 spot at the end of the season, we get to pick our picks at the draft next year. And the rest of you have to throw the ping pong ball. Why would you agree to this? Because we're both 1 and 3, and y'all are ahead of us. We're starting the season on a down note. So, take our bet, take our parlay. We both have to end up in the 1 and 2 spot for this to happen. It's next to impossible. I know I'll be there. I'm just not so sure about Chubb. And next, I face the Chubb. And we have another parlay bet. Wizard Sleevers gets his first win, and the loser of our game that meets him in the 1 and 4 category has to wear that monkey suit next year at the draft. But only if Wizard Sleevers wins. So everybody, cheer on the Wizard Sleevers. He's down on his luck. He's sad. He's a sad dad. That's what your new team name should be, Wizard Sleevers. Wizard Sleevers is an old joke about your vagina, but I know you don't have a vagina anymore because you have a whole child. So you are now currently sad dad. So sad dad, if you win this week and one of us loses, which is inevitable, one of us, the loser, has to wear the monkey suit. Ah, yes, and coming up in the matchup between me and the Chubster, the loser, regardless, has to pick the worst available kicker in the NFL and play that kicker the next week. I'm excited about it. I have Utters Greg versus the W Cone.
Hey, this is whatever my team name is. Austin Eckler, whatever. He's still got the most points on my team this week, so hopefully that doesn't change anytime soon. All right, so I lost my bowl. So it was the milk bowl. So I have a big old Nalgene of milk. I'm standing in my shower to prevent the most mess. I would do it in my yard. Oh, and I'm wearing a She Loves the D shirt. I would do it in the yard, except I just don't want the puppy. We got a puppy, guys, to drink up all of the milk in the ground. So here we go. This is not warm, it's cold. I just poured it out of the fridge, so I am not so excited. I'm not even like a quarter of the way. It's really cold.
Good bets going on. Good bowls. We need more bowls. I have Utters looking on a train to championship town. And I have Utters Greg, high score of the week by like a point. So I have Utters Greg receives his second skin of the season with 132.2. I was coming for it with my 124. I was hoping James Conner would go off just a little bit more and I would get my first high score of the week. I usually have mine by now, but I'm saving it up for my end of the season run all the way to that belt. You'll be surprised when I have that belt. Working that waiver wire. That's what it's all about. And then beating teams. And then having lucky weeks. Yeah. Mostly just lucky weeks. Hi Joe Chubb versus Coors Light and the NASCAR boys. Coors Light almost gets his second skin. Listen. These guys are serious. They're getting skins. To the tune of 2 apiece. Almost. constantly fighting with each other, and it was Oops All Sleepers, but we'll get to that. Oh, how the mighty have always fallen. It's almost the curse of the high score of the week for you to be the Willis of the week. But at least we get a video from Mitch. Coors Light and NASCAR Boys rumbles with 131.3 versus Hyde Yo Chubbs, 119.7. This has got to feel good for Coors Light and the NASCAR Boys. But you know what it isn't? The playoffs. Good news for you, Crazy. You beat him the one time you play him during the regular season, and you don't have to play him again. Mike Evans having a huge game. Austin Hooper really showing up since Adam Thielen laid a big old pooper. Woo! Pooper. There's too many boys to beat. They're coming out like the Warriors. And they're coming for you. They're pushing your little micropenis back and making it look like, you just got a sack with like a mound. Hide your mound. Notable starts in this game. Nick Chubb, of course, hide your mound. The mound himself scoring an amazing 43.3 points. The mound takes the loss against Coors Light and NASCAR Boys. Closest match of the week. This week, the No-Vid Kid versus the Willis Dick Fit in Your Mouth. Willis thought he had this all wrapped up. He said, I'm going to play the Secret Garden and that's going to be the key to victory. But I would say the start of the week for almost any team this week was Jimmy Graham. He believed in Jimmy Graham. He started Jimmy Graham and Jimmy Graham showed up. Boom. 18.1 points. That is your deciding factor. Or you could say that the 3.7 of Tom Brady is really what decided this since it's a 3-point gap. So Tom Brady, had he not scored those 3.7 points, Novid Kid would have lost. So thank you, Tom Brady, for putting up 3.7 points when we thought you couldn't. And Novid Kid comes out on top with a victory. Everybody playing really good defensive streaming this year. Literally the toughest league I'm in for waivers and for streaming and for fucking everything. I really only check this league's score unless I'm playing somebody I know in another league like Andy or Jose. At the end of the day, I'll check my scores. This one I check in on all the time and I look at every single matchup. I care who's winning. I know it's my league, but still, it's like our league, right? So you guys make it so competitive and so fun. And even Will's getting better. Who fucking knew? Who's going to get the belt? I know Perwin's seeing it slip out of his fingers. Impossibly the worst matchup of all time. Touch the fence at 2-2 versus Oops All Sleepers 3-1. And we have our Willis of the Week. That's right, everybody. You are once almost high score 3 times in a row, and then you fall all the way down to the Willis of the Week. 76.2, not our worst score this year. I believe Sleevers still has that. Sad Dad. Give it to Sad Dad. Touch the fence. Showing his teeth. Phillip Lindsay not doing anything. Miles Sanders not doing anything. Julio Jones not doing anything. But if you add them all together, they are a great one player. And that was enough to beat Oops All Sleepers this week. So Touch the Fence gets to sit down, have a little Gatorade on the sidelines, wipe the sweat off his brow, and be satisfied in the fact that he doesn't have to do any penalty laps this week. He is not a sad dad. He is a fine coach, but just fine. Not great, just fine. The only completely defeated team, because finally the MFC proves himself by taking down a titan of an undefeated team in the token minority and becoming a one-win team, one-win man, one-win champion. I'm the one-win champion. That's what I'll change my name to, one-win champion. Wizard Sleeper's still 0-4. Maybe you should think about a name change to get a spark going on your team. Let's call you Sad Dad. Let's call you something like Matty Ice or the Wayne Enterprises. So it's from Batman, Wayne Gallman. So Wayne Enterprises. For you, it was the curse of the bye week, Wizard Sleever / Sad Dad / Wayne Enterprises. 111.4 versus 117, and Dute ekes you out. Didn't get anything out of Mitchell Trubisky. Zero. Goose egg, Mitchell Trubisky. Zero. Still beat Andy. I know Andy's already mad about it, but this is how many that Mitchell Trubisky scored, exactly this many, and you still lost. This many. This many points. That's the amount. Doot-doot-doot-doot-doot continues his melancholy journey all the way to the playoffs because he keeps saying how he sucks. But 2-2 is not a shitty record in this league right now. You're only one game out. Doot, you come out victorious. You roll the 2-2. And we've got Oops All Sleepers making a video for the Willis of the Week or doing something. I mean, I would say that if you're Willis of the Week, you just have to do something. Take a picture of yourself in a vulnerable position. Apologize to us on video. Send us all flowers. Something. If you guys can come up with anything that you think the last place of the week should do, that would be great. We are a quarter way done with the season already, guys, and there has been some excitement. Who do you think is going to end up in the playoffs? Will it be Token Minority and Oops All Sleepers? Will me and Chubb rumble all the way back? Will Wizard Sleepers win out the rest of the season to be the 0-4 start reigning champion and change his name to Starts with Zero or something? Zero to Hero, whatever Chubb and Chump name their teams. Will it be the Will Stick in Your Mouth and we'll all have to eat our words because he'll be wearing the belt and he'll put a jet sticker on it or something? I don't know. But I do know that this week is in the books and we'll see you all next week. And as always, you can go fuck yourself. MSC out.